By now, you've learned how easy it is to create flashcards, practice quizzes, and learning games using StudyMate. You also probably know how to share a StudyMate project with someone else, or how to follow a StudyMate project that someone else created. Now we're going to look at ways to organize your StudyMate projects and the power of using folders. To change the order that projects appear within the My StudyMate Projects list, simply drag them up or down. You can also create a new folder and then drag a project into it. Just like with StudyMate projects, each StudyMate folder has a unique URL. By using the share option, you can email the link for a folder to someone else. But here's what's different when you share a folder that has multiple StudyMate projects. The URL goes to an initial page that lists the StudyMate projects in the folder. The descriptions for the StudyMate projects are also shown. From here, the user selects a StudyMate project, and then the games and learning activities that are available for it. Within StudyMate Campus, you can also follow a folder that's maintained by another user. For example, a student might want to follow a folder created by a classmate, or an instructor might want to follow a folder maintained by another instructor. To follow a folder, select Follow Project, and then enter the URL for the folder. The folder will now appear in your My StudyMate Projects list. An icon will indicate that it's a followed folder, and the author's name is also shown. Expand the folder to view the individual StudyMate projects within it. Just like with a followed project, you don't have editing rights when you follow someone else's folder. And if the original owner makes edits to the folder or the projects within that folder, the changes will appear the next time you select the study option. While it's not possible to edit a folder you're following, you can duplicate a followed folder and then make changes to that copy. To do this, select Duplicate and Edit from the menu and provide a name for the new folder. Now you can edit the duplicated folder by adding new projects to it or making changes to existing ones. Any changes you make will not affect the original StudyMate folder you followed. In fact, you can delete the followed version of the project at any time. One final note. If you're an instructor and you follow a StudyMate folder maintained by someone else, you can still view usage statistics for your own students on that folder. To do this, you need to make the folder available in the course. Now the student usage option will appear for each project in the folder, which lets you see which students access the games and activities. Usage statistics are discussed in another video, so I won't go into more details here. There's so much more you can do with StudyMate, so keep exploring!